Hello guys, I have this case who complained from pain. I took the PA radiograph to diagnose the case, but unfortunately I couldn't because the PA radiograph didn't reveal any abnormality. So here I should jump to the CBCT to determine the exact source of the pain. So today I'm gonna talk about the use of the CBCT in endodontics. We as endodontists mostly use the CBCT for the diagnosis and treatment plan, because the CBCT gives me a lot of information that I cannot get it with the PA radiograph, because the PA radiograph is two-dimensional, while the CBCT is three-dimensional. So with the CBCT, I can move around the tooth, I can know what I have inside the tooth and what I have outside of the tooth. So here a simple differentiation between the 2D and 3D. In the PA radiograph, which is 2D dimension, I can only see the tooth from one side, while with the CBCT, which is 3 dimension, I can move around the tooth, I can know what I have behind the tooth. As any other devices, the CBCT have also the advantage and disadvantage. As you see, we'll take the CBCT for this patient. The disadvantage are only the cost and the dose for the patient, while we have a lot of advantage. First, we can know by the CBCT there's extra canal or not, and it will show us the location of the canal. The second one, we can know the relation of the canals. They are joined or separated. In the case of the instrument fracture, CBCT will show us the exact site and the size of the instrument fracture. CBCT can determine the exact location and the size of the lesions. In the case of the internal and external root resorption, it will be much more easier to diagnose with the CBCT. Finally, in the cases of the vertical root fracture, we can diagnose the case much more easier with the CBCT. So I prepare four cases for you. The first and second one is about the extra canal. The third one about the internal root resorption. And the fourth one is about the vertical root fracture. So let's go and diagnose the case together. So our first case is about the extra canals. So this case, the patient complained about the pain and swelling in the upper six region. So I took the PA, but I couldn't diagnose the source of the pain. But by the CBCT here, as we see, clearly appear that I missed the MB2. And this radiolucent area is the lesion that associated with the mesial root. So our second case is about the anatomical variation and presence of the extra canal and extra roots. This case is lower canine. As you see that it's separated into two separated roots and two separated canals. The two roots are obviously in the both sides. Also, in the coronal view, it's clearly appear that separated into two roots and two canals. Root resorption. As you know that we have internal and external root resorption. This case is upper six. When I manage this case, I face a huge bleeding from the palatal canal. So with the PA, I couldn't diagnose the problem. While with the CBCT, as you see, there's a huge internal root resorption that perforate the palatal wall of the palatal canal. This is the axial view. Also in the coronal view, it's clearly appeared that the resorption area is in the middle third and how it perforates the palatal canal, and we can determine the size and position of the perforation area easily by the CBCT. So as clearly appear our resorption in the middle third of the root. Always the management of the internal resorption should be filled with the MTA. So about the remaining part of the canal, we can obturate it with the cold Gutta-Percha, while the space should be filled with the MTA powder. So our fourth case is about the vertical root fracture. I did a root canal treatment for this case, which is lower seven. After a while, the patient came back and complained about the pain. So I decided to take a CBCT. As you see here, we have a big lesion which surrounds the tooth. And this is the line, which is the fracture line that separates the distal root from the mesial root, which means vertical root fracture. This is the axial view. We can go to the sagittal view. Also, clearly we can see the fracture line that separates the tooth into two pieces. Here we cannot do anything with the root canal, so we should extract the tooth. One of the repeated questions that they asked me a lot of times, is it mandatory to take the CBCT for all of the cases? The answer is no. We should take the CBCT for the case that we cannot diagnose with the PA or we need more information to manage the case. These were a brief explanation about the CBCT and instruction for use in endodontics. We will get to see you in the next video, which is about the polyp biology.